So, Robby, first of all, let's dispense with this right away. The IG report says that at times, Comey himself used his personal email for government business, a Gmail account. Comey said there was nothing classified. I know Clinton supporters point to this as hypocrisy, but just because Comey used a personal email, does that make it right?
No, and Hillary said on the campaign trail it was a mistake to have the personal email server. I think what's just in retrospect incredibly ironic and deeply frustrating to a lot of us is that Director Comey felt entitled to go in front of the country unauthorized and lecture Secretary Clinton about her use when it turns out he was doing the same thing. But, you know, at this point, I don't think it's something we should spend a lot of time dwelling on. I just think it speaks to the larger issue here about Comey's judgment that he never should have done this in the first place.
Well, let's talk about the larger issue. I mean, the Inspector General blasted Comey's handling of the case. He said that they found, quote, no evidence that Comey's July statement tearing into Clinton's email habits as extremely careless was the result of bias or an effort to influence the election. Do you accept that Comey wasn't biased or trying to tip the scales?
I do. I think Comey is a patriotic person. I would like to give him the benefit of the doubt and believe that he was doing what at the time he thought was right, but it was a mistake. And I think his belief that there was an exception to the rule really proved the rule. These protocols are in place to prevent the FBI from inadvertently or advertently influencing an election. And I think this is a case where he did influence the election. And frankly, I wish he would be more candid. I think he believes it was a mistake too. I really do. And this report is helpful in that, you know, the information is out there. And I hope that it gives the professional men and women at the FBI a chance to reflect on why this really should never happen again.
What do you make of you know, the new text messages that were revealed? I mean, the IG investigation is looking at Peter Strzok's emails, obviously, text messages with Lisa Page, and also three other FBI employees that, according to the Inspector General, included statements of hostility toward then candidate Trump and statements of support for candidate Clinton. Don't President Trump supporters have reason to be suspicious and angry, certainly, about that particular text exchange?
Well, they were certainly inappropriate statements. And I think that this report is an important moment for the FBI. It's probably a good gut check for all of them that the things they say matter, the correspondence they have matters. Their institution is incredibly powerful, but that also means that they're held to an incredibly high standard. And the other thing that was in that report is how much people were leaking constantly about the investigation into Secretary Clinton. And you even see in the messages there an acknowledgement by the staff that the leaks that they are putting out, the information that they're shuffling around, could have a real impact on the election. And so I think this is a really important cautionary story to everybody working at the FBI. They just have to follow the line. And there are examples here up and down the chain where that just didn't happen.
Robby, just stand by. I'm going to talk a little bit to Republican Congressman Chris Stewart, and then I'll bring you back in. We'll all discuss this. Congressman Stewart is a member of the House Intelligence Committee. Congressman, thanks for being with us. So the IG's report said that they quote, found no evidence that the conclusions by department prosecutors were affected by bias or other improper considerations. For you, does this report put to bed any belief or concerns there may have been about the FBI's investigation to Hillary Clinton?
Well, some of it, I guess. But it's hard to read some of, as you were just indicating, Anderson, it's hard to read some of the texts that were exchanged between some of these FBI officials and not realize there's enormous political animus taking place there. And whether it affected their judgment, whether it affected the actual outcome of their investigation, the IG said that it didn't, still makes many of us uncomfortable. I do want to say first, thanks to the IG for what is it seems to be a very thorough work. I think the FBI director, Mr. Ray, said it right. It leaves many of us disappointed. Loretta Lynch was faulted for her leadership, and Director Comey, as you were just discussing, finding out he's using a personal email while criticizing and investigating Hillary Clinton for doing the same and the leaks. And I mean, no one in this turns out looking very good at the end of the day.
It was interesting. I mean, though they said no bias was found, that in the one case with that Peter Strzok text, or excuse me, in the one case by in Peter Strzok's decision to prioritize the Russia investigation over looking more into Anthony Weiner's emails until later, that they could not determine whether or not there was bias in that decision.
Yeah, I think it's really important to note that there's clearly bias in their political views. I mean, there's just no question about that, and very emotional bias. But the Inspector General said that that wasn't reflected in the outcome of the investigation or in their conclusions. Once again, I don't dispute that, but it does make, I think, most Americans uncomfortable to look at senior FBI officials who have such strong emotional political views against one candidate, knowing that they are investigating at the time, although for different reasons, both of these candidates. It doesn't make the FBI senior leadership, it does not cast them in a very positive light.
The Inspector General does say that the rationale that Director Comey used not to prosecute Hillary Clinton, that her handling of classified information wasn't so gross as to almost suggest deliberate intention, which is the standard, was the same rationale that the FBI used in 2008 when they decided not to charge former Attorney General Alberto Gonzalez with mishandling classified documents. Yeah. So if that was an okay standard in 2008, do you believe it was okay to use that standard vis-a-vis Hillary Clinton?
Yeah, you know, I've never disputed the conclusion that the director came to. I think most of us dispute and have trouble with how he publicly presented it. And the Inspector General did as well. He called him actually insubordinate for that, because he did it so that he wouldn't convey that decision onto his boss, the Attorney General, Loretta Lynch, who may have had input and may have had a different opinion on that. And by the way, it was ultimately her decision whether to prosecute or not, not the FBI's. So I don't necessarily disagree with his conclusion whether it was prosecutable or not. It was the very public way that he presented that decision that many people have a real problem with.
Oh, I want to bring Robby Mook back into the discussion. It is interesting, Robby, today we've heard from, you know, Democrats and Republicans that you know, both sides sort of see different things in this, or there's enough in this report that both sides you know, have valid points and raise valid arguments.
Yeah, I appreciate that, but let's be clear about something. I did not hear a single Republican speaking out against Director Comey until the president chose to fire him. And I want to be very clear from my standpoint, the finding in this report was absolutely should not be something that President Trump tries to hide behind as an excuse for why he fired Director Comey. He fired Director Comey because he wanted to stop the Russia investigation, not because he felt sympathy for Hillary Clinton. This is the same campaign that was leading chants of lock her up during the campaign. So I worry there's a false equivalency developing where an opinion that I and other people who were working with Secretary Clinton have held consistently, and the president who suddenly decided he didn't like Director Comey when he was the one facing heat for the potential relationship his campaign had with Russia.
You know, I have to counter that just very quickly, and that is there were some Republicans who were critical of Director Comey before he was fired, and frankly, I was one of them. Beginning in the fall of the election, I was fairly public, although gentle, if you will, in my criticism of some of the things that we were seeing from the director in the Intelligence Committee and some of his testimony before the committee. And it wasn't directly related to Secretary Clinton and the email investigation, but there were other things that we were becoming very uncomfortable with, and we were fairly open about that.
Congressman, do you agree at all with Robby's argument that James Comey did far more damage to Hillary Clinton, costing her the election, than it ever did to President Trump?
I can understand why he would believe that. I think it's impossible to know. I mean, it truly is actually impossible to know.
Is there tangible damage to President Trump that Comey's investigation into Hillary Clinton did?
No. I understand why he would say that. But whether you could conclude that that's why she lost the election, and it's fair, by the way, to point out that at the end of the day, she is responsible for that. She is the one who decided to use this email server. She's the one who hid it. She's the one who destroyed 30,000 of her emails that should have been saved and protected. I mean, there's a number of things that she did that led us to this point. Now, once again, I know that there's criticism the way that the FBI director handled that. There's no question it had some impact on the election. But I don't think anyone conclude that Donald Trump is a president because of that. I think there's many, many more explanations and reasons for that.
Robby, I want you to be able to respond to that.
Yeah, look, I've been pretty clear in the past. I don't think it is possible to scientifically quantify the impact. And from my standpoint, I don't think that's a productive discussion. I think the fact of the matter here is that the director of the FBI made a very bad judgment. I wish he would own up to that so that his so that future directors can learn this lesson. I think this report has a lot for everybody at the FBI to think about. But what I don't want to come out of this is that this somehow becomes a shield for President Trump to obstruct an investigation that, by the way, the FBI was doing at the same time. We never heard leaks about it. We did hear a lot of leaks about Hillary Clinton. And so I don't want this this false narrative that Democrats say one thing, Republicans say another. We've been saying for months and years even that the FBI was mishandling this. But that is no excuse for Donald Trump to turn around today and say that the people have no right to get to the bottom of what his campaign may or may not have done with Russia.
Just finally, Congressman Stewart, do you have confidence in Director Wray that he's going to right the wrongs that
took
place?
I do, and unlike Director Comey, he seems to be much less interested in his public perception than he is in actually managing and leading the FBI. As you said earlier, we don't see him much before the cameras. He seems to be someone who wants to work behind the scenes, and I believe that he's sincere in his comments today. We can do better than this. We're going to do better. I think the American people should take some relief in that. And by the way, the good news is he's united Republicans and Democrats. We both are frustrated with some of the decisions that he's made.
Congressman Stewart, Robby Mook, I appreciate both your times. Thanks so much.
You.